Hello friends, welcome back. Today in this video we will be working on a new sensor which is an analog to digital converter, and that is MCP3426. So for more info about this sensor, let's go to controleverything.com and here search for our sensor, that is MCP3426. Here it is. It is a 16-bit 2-channel analog to digital converter, and some of its more important features are mentioned here. You can also buy this sensor from here. Today we'll be interfacing this sensor with a particle photon, and for that the main requirement is of code. So click on resource tab and here you'll find the particle code sample for MCP3426. Click on it and you can download all the code from here as a zip file. You can also have the codes from our GitHub repository, which is Control Everything Community. Now we need some hardware for interfacing and working of the sensor, so let's move to that part. In the hardware connections part, first thing we need is a particle photon, and this is an I2C shield. It is available on the website controleverything.com and you can purchase it from there. The reason we are using this is to make easy connections with other I2C devices. So gently place particle photon over the I2C shield and make a connection like this. Now to power up our particle photon, we need a micro USB cable just like this. Insert it in the power jack of the particle photon. This is our sensor MCP3426 and this is a connecting cable. Connect the sensor with connecting cable like this, and while making connection, make sure the brown wire of the cable should be connected to the ground of the sensor, and the same rule applies to the I2C shield. And with this we are done with the hardware part. Now let's move on to the interfacing and working of the sensor. For the interfacing part, first of all, we need to log in to github.com, and here we have to search for the repository, which is Control Everything Community. Click on it and here search for the sensor MCP3426. Here is our sensor and this is the particle code. But first, let's see the instructions we have to follow. Log in to your photon and set up your device according to the steps provided at this link. Please go through this link and note down all the relevant steps you will need to set up your particle photon on different platforms like Mac and Windows. Please do it carefully. After that, we have to download or git pull the code, and we have to copy the code on online IDE, and this is the link for the online IDE. Later on, we have to verify and flash the code, and the code output is shown at dashboard, and this is the link for the dashboard. Please note it down. With this, we are done with the instructions. Now let's get back to the code. This is our particle code with .ino extension, and this is the code. Firstly, in the code we have included some header file, which is application.h and spark wiring i2c.h. Later we have defined the i2c address of MCP3426 here, which is 0x68. In the void setup, we have set some variables here, and we have initialized the I2C communication and set baud rate of 9600 here. In the writing part, we have selected the configuration command 0x10, in which we have selected continuous conversion mode, channel 1 and 12 bit of resolution. Later, we have given a delay of 300 milliseconds. In while loop, we have selected the data register 0x00, from which we are requesting and reading 2 bytes of data, which is raw ADC MSV and raw ADC LSV. Later, we are converting the data to 12 bits according to the formula given in the MCP3426 datasheet. Later, we are output the data to dashboard from this command. And with this, we are done with the interfacing of the sensor. Now let's see the working and performance of this sensor.
For the working part, first of all, we have to copy the entire particle code. And then we have to open the build.particle.io link, which we have discussed in the instructions part. Here we have to create a new file with MCP3426 name. And then we have to save our code. Now we have to verify and compile our code. The code is now compiling and it's a great work. Now we have to flash the code. While flashing the code, we have to check for the magenta flash on the device. Right now we have just received the confirm of magenta flash on the device. Now let's see the output on the dashboard.particle.io link. Now you can see the initial value is 0 because nothing is connected to the channel 1 of the sensor. But when I connect a 1.5 volt of battery to the channel 1, you can see the output is now 850. It is almost constant because the battery is connected to the channel continuously. So this is how the sensor works. Now let's move to the application and features part. Let's see.
The sensor is a 16-bit analog to digital converter with differential inputs. It is a low noise and high accuracy 16-bit delta sigma analog to digital converter. It is the family member of MCP342X series from the Microchip technology. The device can output analog to digital conversion results at rate of 15, 60 or 240 samples per second depending on the user controllable configuration bit settings. The device have two conversion modes, one-shot conversion mode and continuous conversion mode. The application includes portable instrumentation and consumer goods, temperature sensing with RTD and thermocouple, bridge sensing for pressure, strain and force, weigh scales and battery fuel gauges, factory automation equipment and many more like this. This sensor can be purchased from our website, that is controleverything.com. You can download the code from resource type and after that as a zip file. Also, you can have the code from our GitHub repository, which is Control Everything Community. In the end, I would like to clear, if you have any further queries regarding the interfacing and working of the sensor, you can reach us on controleverything.com and you can also post comments on our community page. For articles and blogs on various sensors like this, you can look us on instructable.com and you can subscribe our YouTube channel for more video tutorials like this. In the end, I hope you enjoyed the video and have a good day.